In this video, we will be looking at our first classification algorithm called logistic regression. Note that this is a, even though the name regression is sitting there, it is actually a classification algorithm. So, in the previous videos, we saw linear regression, which tries to fit an optimal, usually least squares fit to some given data using weights which are linear. So, now in this video, we will look at the idea of trying to classify two different sets of data for binary classification. By binary classification, I mean that there are two possible classes. We label these classes simply 1 and 0. These are the labels that we are giving our classes. So, suppose you collect some bunch of examples, and once you plot them, let us say x1 and x2 are two features. Of your data, and you are classifying your data according to this. Okay. Now, what you see when you plot the figure is that they nicely cluster to one side or the other side, and intuitively we can draw a line separating the two. Okay. The separating or the classifying line. Now, can we use our linear regression idea in order to achieve some sort of classification of this sort? Okay. So, here is the problem. You are given x1 and x2, which is your input x vector. You have a bunch of examples. Each of these data points is an example. So, as we used with linear regression, we will use the same notation. So on and so forth. Once again, we will use m examples. This is our input, and our output as before is y. Now, unlike linear regression, remember that our output has to be one of two classes, either in this case the red class or the green class, which is class 1 or class 0. So, our label y should always be either 0 or 1, 0 or 1, okay, always. And we have to make, our job is to get a predictive model which does the same. Ideally, it should classify this as 0 whenever this is 0 and as 1 whenever it is 1, and of course, we would like to do this for new points as well, okay, for some extra new point which has been now introduced. So, how can we do this? Suppose we try simple linear regression. There would be a problem. What is that problem? So, suppose I introduce a new point somewhere here. Okay. If I had fit a simple linear regression line, whatever model I use, if I use a linear model, y hat equal to, let us say, w0 plus w1 x1 plus w2 x2. Regardless of your weights w1 and w2, if I pick up a far enough point, this value will come very high. It is not going to lie between 0 and 1. Similarly, if I choose a point at the extremum, there is no way for you to ensure that a simple linear model will always give values between 0 and 1. So, which is why we use a very simple idea, which is to squish all data to the range 0, 1, which is what we require as our output. How do we do this? Once again, there is a very simple idea for this. We use something called the sigmoid function. So, sigmoid function is defined as follows: 1 by 1 plus e to the power minus z. What does it look like? You can see its limits. As z tends to infinity, sigmoid of z tends to 1, because e to the power minus z tends to 0. As z tends to minus infinity, sigmoid of z tends to 0, because this tends to infinity. Now, exactly at z equals to 0, sigmoid of z is equal to 0.5. Notice also that this is a monotonic function. So, if you plot the sigmoid curve, it looks somewhat like this. At x equal to 0, the sigmoid value is 0.5. As it tends to infinity, it is going to be 1, and as x tends to minus infinity, it is going to tend to 0. So, what this tells us is, if I predict y hat as, instead of using what I had for linear regression, if I use sigmoid of linear regression, this would tell me that y hat will always lie between 0 and 1. Now, this has an additional advantage, which is, now we can interpret y hat as the probability that your output belongs to class 1 given the input x. Let me explain. Now, let us look at this line here. Okay. We want this value, let us call this something z. Okay. This value z, which is equal to w 0 plus some weights w 1 x 1 plus w 2 x 2. Such that if it has to lie in class 1, then z has to be really high. Okay. If it has to belong to class 0, we know that z has to be really low. Okay. Now, suppose I look at a point which is somewhere here, let us say this is a new point. What this tells me is that this point is almost certain to lie in class 1, just looking at this data. The further away we get away from this classifying line, then more and more certain we are that this point belongs to class 1. Similarly, the further away we get to this side of the line, the further and further closer we certain we are that we belong to class 0. Okay. So, what we can think of z as is, z is the perpendicular distance from the classifying line. How does that help us? The classifying line then is the line z equal to 0, which means sigmoid of z is equal to 0.5. If I come to this side, sigmoid of z becomes close to 1. If I come to this side, sigmoid of z becomes close to 0. The closer I am to this line, the more uncertain we are about where it lies, or whether it lies on class 1 or whether it lies on class 0. Therefore, it is easy to now interpret y hat, which was equal to sigmoid of z, as the probability that you belong to class 1. For example, if your sigmoid value is close to 0.5, then what it means is you are not really certain about how close it is to class 1. It means probability is approximately 0.5 that it is class 1. Let us say sigmoid is close to 0.99, then we know that it is really far away and that we are very, very certain that it lies to class, that it lies in class 1. Suppose let us say the sigmoid value is 0.01, then we know that the probability that it lies in class 1 is actually pretty low, it is equal to 0.01. So, this is the simple idea behind logistic regression. We will see how to compute classifying lines using logistic regression in later videos.